Now in this chapter of the rolling, the rotational motion of the rigid bodies, I am telling you today the rolling motion of the body on the inclined plane. So we have to find the velocity, the acceleration and the time taken to cross the inclined plane. So let's this is the inclined plane. This is now A, B, this is now ground, this is now point B, here is the body. This is a body. This is falls from here and its initial velocity is equal to zero, u is equal to zero. This is rolling. So it has both kinds of the motion, the translational and that the rotational. Let this angle is theta and this is now height h from the ground. So when the body is rolling down, then it will take some time to cross this inclined plane AB, and also it will have the acceleration, so that we have to find the expression for that, because sometimes this is asked in the NEET exam, that when suppose two or three bodies like the cylinder, sphere and that the ring, disc, they are rollings together on the inclined plane, then which of them will reach the bottom first and which will be the which will reach at the last of this inclined plane. So let m equal to mass of the body. The body is moving freely, so this initial velocity here, it will be equal to zero, and let the velocity at this point, this is now supposed to be, the body reaches here and it has got the velocity that is now equal to v. So this we have to find. Now then we can have the conservation of the energy. So that will be the total energy at the point A equal to total energy at the point B. So at point A, at point A, now this U is equal to zero. And let the length of this plane is equal to AB. L equal to length of inclined plane. Inclined plane. AB. So now, using the law of conservation of energy, apply law of conservation of energy. What we have, the total energy at point A, total energy at point B equal to total energy at point A. So So total energy at point B. This is now your half m v square into 1 plus k square upon r square into at the point B the height h is equal to 0. So this is now your mg and this is now h equal to 0. This is equal to at point A. This is now half m velocity is equal to 0 plus mg h. At point A, we are having this velocity equal to 0, height is equal to h, and that at the point B, we have the velocity, this energy is so much, and the h is equal to 0, so this term will come out to be equal to 0. So now from here, we can have the relation, this 1 by 2 mb square into 1 plus k square upon r square equal to mgs. Now this m and m will cancel. So velocity, this is equal to 2gh into 1 plus k square upon r square. This is now square root of so much. And now from here you can see that the velocity is dependent upon the height of the inclined plane. And also it depends upon k square upon r square. This is now expression for velocity. This is the number 1. Now the acceleration. So for acceleration, A. So for this we will use the formula v square equal to u square plus 2as. The third equation of motion, and v is equal to so much, this is given to here. So this is now 2gh upon 1 plus k square upon r square equal to u. U is equal to 0 here. And this is now 2as. S is equal to l. The length of this inclined plane. This s equal to l. So now we can have now this is equal to 2gh upon 1 plus k square upon r square equal to 2al. Now this 2 will cancel from here, and we know that this h equal to l sin theta. So in place of h we will write down this l sin theta. So this is now g into l sin theta upon 1 plus k square upon r square equal to al. So this l will cancel, and from here this, therefore this a is equal to g sin theta upon 1 plus k square upon r square. This is now for a. And you see from here that this A is independent of the height and the length of the plane. End of time taken. So for that we will use this equation first or the equation second. Time taken. That is now t. So this s equal to ut plus half a t square. Using the second equation of motion. And you will see from here. Now this S that is equal to L equal to this is now your 0 plus half A. This is now your G sin theta into 1 plus K square upon R square into T square. This is not so much. So now you can see that this T will be equal to, therefore T is equal to, this is now your 2L into 1 plus K square upon R square upon G sin theta. G sin theta. This is not time taken. This is so much. So this is now number 2 and here this is now number 3. So you see from here that the time taken is independent of, this is now square root of so much. Square root of so much. The time t does not depend upon the height of the plane, but it depends upon the length of the plane. So now conclusions are, conclusions, the velocity velocity acceleration and time depend upon the factor k square upon r square. This term is coming in all the three formula. The velocity does not depend upon length of the plane. So length is not coming there with the height h. So if we replace the height h by this l sin theta, then this will make the same thing. So this is dependent upon, this is independent of the length of the plane. The acceleration does not depend upon length and height of the plane. Now h kitna hai, l kitna hai, isse koi lena dena nahi hai. Iske andar this only depends upon k square upon r square. The time t taken depends upon length of the plane. This may L I have from this L. So this T is proportional to square root of L. This is no relationship. And you can see from here that if this body does not roll, or it has only the linear motion, or this is now slipping down the inclined plane. If the body does not roll on the inclined plane, or the body slips down the plane, then this k square upon r square, this term is equal to 0. It means that this will have only the translatory motion, no rolling motion at all. So in all of these terms, this k square upon r square will be eliminated. And then you can see the velocity v, this will be equal to square root of 2gh, and acceleration a, this will be equal to g sin theta, and time integral will be equal to 2l upon g sin theta. And time t equal to square root of 2l upon g sin theta. So all the terms will eliminate. So this is when the body is having the only translatory motion, and when the body having the rolling motion, then we will have the term k square upon r square. And for different bodies, the k square upon r square is different. So we can have for ring, k square upon r square equal to 1, and for disc and cylinder, k square upon r square equal to 1 by 2, and that your sphere k square upon r square equal to 2 by 5, and for a thin rod, this k square upon r square, this is equal to 1 by 12. So you can see from here that if suppose these bodies are allowed to roll on the inclined plane, then the time will be taken minimum, that is for the rod. Because for rod this is equal to 1 by 12. So first the rod will cross this inclined plane and it will reach the bottom, and then this is not 2 by 5, this is not 0.4. So after this rod, there will the sphere that will reach at the bottom, and these two bodies will reach simultaneously, and this ring will reach at the last of all these bodies. So having the knowledge of this k square upon r square, we can compare that which of the body will take the maximum time and which of them will take the minimum time. So is smaller the value of k square upon r square, then is smaller the value of the time. So we have the factor that this time is taken less for the bodies having k square upon r square, the minimum value. So this is about the velocity, acceleration and the time taken of the body rolling on the inclined plane. So you like, share and subscribe this video and share it as much as possible to your friends who are studying in the same stream and the same class. So thank you very much.